Very good afternoon, members of the Taxpayer Association. Very good afternoon to the members of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh Taxpayer Association and the Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce and Industry to this interactive meeting with Sri J.B. Malhopatra, IRS Principal CCIT, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh State, on the issues and resolution under Vivad Se Vishwas scheme. So now I request our President, C.A. Ramdev Putra, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh Association, for his welcome address.
Thank you, Ritesh. Good afternoon to all the participants. I welcome you all. And I am delighted to welcome Principal Chief Commissioner, Income Tax, Telangana and AP, Sri J.B. Mohapatra, sir. And also I am delighted to recognize the presence of senior officials from the Income Tax Department, including Madam Preeti Garg, Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, Hyderabad 1, B. Jay Kumar, sir, Principal Commissioner, Hyderabad 4, Sri M. Anil Kumar, sir, Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, Vijayawada, and of course, Piyush Sonkar, sir, is CIT admin at Hyderabad. And also, I welcome Niju Gupta, madam, additional commissioner looking after this Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, and other officials and dignitaries. I am also delighted to welcome all the my senior professional colleagues, including our past presidents, Sri Devidas sir, and others who have joined. And friends, this meeting was necessitated due to so many queries which have been raised by our members under Vivad Se Vishwas. Many or few of them still planning to file. Because of some confusions, they are unable to do it. Those who have filed, they got some technical issues or differences in what they have filed in their form 1 and what they have been got in form 3. So how to resolve all these issues is not a big issue, in fact. Of course, as when we met a few days back with Mohapatra sir, he informed us that some local level coordination committee is also constituted to sort out all these issues and is helpful. Friends, regarding this Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, on apparently face, it appears to be a very good one. It is really a good opportunity. It saves us from litigations. So avoiding litigation, we can save our time, energy and money, which we can utilize productively for other works of our business, profession, whatever it may be. So we should try to avail this scheme instead of going in litigation. After all, this scheme is only asking us to pay tax at 30% maximum, which was there earlier. So this scheme is more beneficial than litigation. Of course, I am not thrusting any view, but apparently it appears to me that it is a very good scheme which must be utilized. And as we know, our Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce and Industry stalwarts also joined. So they are also looking for this opportunity. They want to know more for it. So with this brief, I welcome you all to this very important webinar on. And also I request our Mohapatra sir, if any other information, kindly note down and if possible, answer those queries also, which issues, if any there. So with this brief, Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce Industries, Ram.
Thank you, Ramdevji. On behalf of FPCCI and Tax Bar Association, I extend my warm welcome to Sri J.B. Mohapatra, the IRS Principal Chief Commissioner of Income Tax, Telangana and AP, and other senior officials of the department, Sri S.B. Kabraji, advisors of our FPCCI Direct Access Committee, and co-chairs, Sri Ramdev ji and Ritesh Mittal ji of FPCCI, representatives of Telangana and AP Tax Bar Association, distinguished participants. The government has rolled out Vivad Se Vishwas scheme under, in line with the one introduced for the indirect taxes, which was introduced in March 2020. And considering the pandemic situation, the scheme has been suitably extended time and again. As per the latest notification dated 27th October, the last date to file declaration under the said act is 31st December. It is laudable that the board has released FAQs and provide clarifications from time to time with a view to remove difficulties faced by the SSEs. Sir, we sought your clarification. If the appeal is filed late before any appellate authority with an application for condemnation of delay, will it amount to appeal pending as on 31 January 2020? As in such case, appeal has to be admitted by the appellate authority only after condoning the delay.
Ida, Ida.
Interaction will clear the doubts of the participant. Thank you.
Thank you, Ramakanji, sir. Now I request Principal CCIT Sri J.V. Mohapatra, sir, to take over, present his views on Vivad Se Vishwas, and also take up the queries and issues which have been raised by the participants here. Sri Mohapatra, sir, please. Your voice is muted, sir. You are not audible. Please unmute yourself.
Yes. My grateful thanks to the Tax Bar and to the Chamber of Commerce of APN Telangana for having arranged this particular webinar in respect of the Vivad Se Vishwas scheme. Giving a brief overview of the scheme, came into being with the enactment in the Parliament in March 2020. It had a shelf life initially up to June 2020. Then now, it is set to die down by 31st of December 2020. So from today, that is 23rd of December, we have good 8 days to go before the scheme closes down. The scheme closing down is meaning that the declarants will not make any application after 31st of December 2020. So this has to be kept in mind. Now, the rollout of this scheme is entirely online and electronic, meaning thereby in the e-filing portal of the department.
Just a moment, sir. I'll do one thing, and I'll remove the access for everyone to unmute themselves, and then I'll unmute you, sir. Just a minute. Give me 2 seconds, sir. Mute all. Then now release to unmute themselves. Yes, take out this access.
It's okay.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Done, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes.
So I'll just say, the DTBSP Act is only is a very brief act of the Parliament. It's only 12 sections, and the forms which are related to the Act are only 5. In Form 1 and 2, you give the declaration and the undertaking. Form number 3 is what is given by the designated authority back to the declarant, saying that this is your this is the disputed tax, and Form 4 is the taxpayer's submission to the designated authority, saying that I have paid my taxes and I am also enclosing the proof of withdrawal of my appeals for you. And Form 5 is the certificate issued by the designated authority, saying that this is your full and final certificate, and all proceedings and everything there contained in the certificate makes it clear that you have made a valid application and we have accepted your application. So this is as far as the scheme of the act is concerned. Now, how we are planning to roll out in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana is that each of the taxpayer in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana is mapped in the sense that a designated authority is having jurisdiction of anybody in AP and Telangana who wants to file a form number 1 and 2. There are as many as 12 designated authorities. For example, in Hyderabad, we have the PCIT 1, 2, 4, then PCIT Central, then we have the CIT TDS also, then CIT Exemption. So they are all the designated authorities in Andhra Pradesh, in Telangana. And in that manner, we have the PCIT in Vijayawada, PCIT in Tirupati, PCIT in Visakhapatnam, PCIT Central also in Visakhapatnam, CIT Central in Visakhapatnam, and the CIT TDS in Vijayawada. They are also designated authorities. So any declarant who is a declarant under the terms of the Act, he can file his form number 1 electronically to any of the designated authorities. Because as you know, income tax by itself is a complicated act to administer. We cannot say that the DTVSB 2020, although it is very short and very cryptic, it does not throw up challenges for interpretation. All your queries cannot be answered in one seminar or two seminars. For that particular purpose, the board, through its communication of April 2020 and December 2020, has called nearly 89 questions, relevant questions, the FAQ, and it has tried to answer in terms of the administration of the Act. So there are 89 answers already available. Many of the queries which you may be raising may have been answered in the FAQ, which have already been answered by the board. So kindly, for the benefit of everybody who is present here, many of the queries, individual queries, they are so typically complicated that one seminar or one sitting may not even be able to answer to your query. It requires little thinking, or rather deep thinking, of a group of people in order to come to a point who can be a declarant, number one, because the issue with regard to a declarant also, that is also very vexatious, in the sense that we have to find out, you know, there are cases in which a declarant or a so-called declarant will come under the scheme and try to get into the scheme. But at the end of the day, it may be so found that the facts stated are not entirely correct. Maybe there is no valid appeal also at that for the declarant to come under the scheme. So there are issues. So my point is that individual queries in the seminar may not be difficult, may be difficult to answer, right? But I will give you a broad overview of the administration of the scheme. The scheme will allow a valid declarant to pay only 100% of the taxes and get relief from interest, penalty, and future prosecution if contemplated. In case of searches, it is 100% of taxes plus 25%, that is 125% of the taxes. In case the assessee or the taxpayer has owned previously its any of the issues in any appellate fora, then the tax rate becomes half. If it is a departmental appeal, this is a scheme where the taxpayer holds the leverage of regulating even the departmental appeals. Even in a departmental appeal, the taxpayer can disarm the departmental appeal by paying 50% of the disputed amount and making the department withdraw the appeal. So this is one of a kind scheme where the taxpayer is holding the department and its own affairs in its own hands and deciding whether to litigate, by itself, or whether to litigate, or whether to let the department litigate, or whether to stop the litigation both at its own level and at the level of the department. So this is a case, this is a scheme which benefits immensely the taxpayers. A tax liability, whether a bigger case or a smaller case, not only brings lot of tension in your minds, but it also impairs the assets which you have created. The underlying assets which have been created out of the disputed demand, they are undervalued, whether tangibly or intangibly, because of the litigation. This is a good opportunity to all the taxpayers in AP and Telangana who can come under the scheme and get the benefits out of the scheme. And the scheme also very categorically says that even if the taxpayer goes under the scheme and accepts a particular view, that view is not setting a precedent in his case, meaning thereby neither the department will say nor the taxpayer will claim later on that the opposite, the counterparty, has acquiesced or has conceded its tax position. This is an inbuilt provision which decides that the privacy, the tax privacy between the department and the taxpayer is only relatable to that particular year in which you are coming under the scheme. It is not going to affect your future affairs. Department is never going to, under the statute, department is never going to say in a later year that because you have conceded your tax position in that year under the scheme, so I am going to make similar, I will take similar view in a future year. That is not allowed, and it is a sovereign guarantee. It is enshrined in the terms of the Act. So this is one of the great and remarkable feature of this Act. And the last point I want to say is that no court of law, no arbitrator, no conciliator can get into and adjudicate on any certificate or any decision of the designated authority, meaning thereby the designated authority's view on admission, non-admission, quantification of tax, determination of the amount payable under the VSB, they are full and final. So these are the scheme of the Act. As I told earlier, there are designated authorities across AP and Telangana, 12 in all, who are going to take cognizance of all the applications to be filed, and they will issue the certificates as per law. Initially, the form number 3 is to be issued within 15 days. And then after the taxpayer submits the form number 4, the form number 5 will follow. So there are 12 designated authorities in charge of deciding the applications. They will receive applications online, Saturdays, Sundays included, electronically they will receive and they will process. And also, because designated authorities, maybe at points of time, they have their own apprehensions about administration of a particular term or a particular application. So we have set up two local coordination committee, one at Hyderabad under PCIT1, Preeti Garg, and one in Vijayawada under PCIT Anil Kumar. So these two local coordination committee, they are to resolve the local issues with the jurisdictional officers, right? And if they are not able to resolve those issues, they are flagged to the office of the principal chief. And if those cannot be resolved here, then we escalate those matters to the board for a resolution. So there is a seamless process of interpreting difficult cases coming under VSB and how to pilot them through the whole process so that the declarant gets a certificate the form number 5 at the end of the day. So my short point, summing up everything, I would again remind you that there are only a few days left, just about a full week, some 8 or 10 days left now. This is the right time to go if there is a valid declarant. This is the right time to go under the scheme, get the benefit of the scheme, and also to settle the tax disputes in the most beneficial manner possible. I will end at that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mohapatra, sir. Now, I request the participants who want to have some issues, they can briefly raise here. Also, can they put their questions in the chat box also? And for this further conduct, I request Ritesh Mittal to please, being host of the virtual meeting, please conduct the proceedings. I invite all the members who have their grievances or queries or issues, please share in brief so that maximum queries can be taken up. Also, you can share your queries in chat box also. Ritesh, please continue.
Yes, sir. So, sir, what I have done is members can unmute themselves and can ask the query, or else they can put the queries in the chat box also. It is up.
Ritesh, I have got a question.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. SB Kavach, please proceed.
I have got a question. Sir, in the last week, one of my clients is surveyed. Now we are coming forward under this scheme. What are the rate applicable under this scheme to the survey, sir? Why they are using the word search? They are not using the word survey in this scheme, sir.
Can I take that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Please.
No, survey, etc. They are not specifically referred in the scheme. But if your client was surveyed last week, has no bearing on the scheme. The scheme says that if any tax dispute in any appellate forum exists as on 31st of January 2020, then only it will be a valid declaration. If your client was surveyed last week, it has no bearing on the scheme.
Thank you, sir.
Ritesh, I have got a query.
Yes, sir.
This is Ramesh Jain, Chalagonin here, sir. I have got two queries, sir. One is, the assessment order under section 144 was served on the assessee on 31st of January by way of physical delivery. It was uploaded on OLTAS, but since it was a section 144 order, the assessee could not see the order. So he has filed an appeal on 2nd of February. Though the time limit has lapsed from the date of uploading, but the date of service by physical copy is still valid. So is that declaration can be made for that? And secondly, sir, in my assessee's case, there was 2 appeals pending with the tribunal. In one case, the tribunal has set aside to the CIT appeals. In the second case, the tribunal has set aside to assessing officer. So can I make a declaration when the assessment has been set aside to AO?
If Priti Garg can come in.
Hello.
Ritesh, madam ko spot mein le.
Yes, sir. Please, madam. Priti Garg, madam, you are on spotlight. Madam.
Hello. Yes.
Please go ahead, madam. You can. Yes.
Yes. The query, two queries have been raised. One is regarding service of a notice, service of the assessment order.
Yeah, ma'am.
So, as per the facts shown, the order has been served on 31st January itself. So, I believe it cannot be said that if it has been seen by the assessee later, we cannot take that into account, because in another case, assessee may see it after 15 days, he may be out of station. How do we allow an assessee who's seen it after one day and assessee who's seen after 15 days be on the same parallel? I don't think we can allow that. But anyway, case to case, we can have a look at it. Another query, sir, they raised is if ITT has set aside to CIT appeal or set aside to AO. When it is set aside to CIT appeal, certainly it is a pending appeal, and I'm sure we can go ahead with it. As regards whether it is set aside to AO, in case the set aside order says that for fresh opportunity only, then it is certainly covered under the scheme. If the order says that it is to be made a de novo assessment, on that part, one of the FAQs says we cannot take that into account. He is not eligible. So, but I remember going through the FAQs yesterday, and in one of the cases, one reply, it appeared as if they are saying the other way around also. I will check on that and we will inform the committee. You may raise the issue there. We will confirm on this point once again. Is your point taken care of, Mr. Jain?
Yes. Next.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Yes.
Next. Next, I think Devidas sir have some queries.
Yes, sir.
Devidas sir.
Devidas sir.
Devidas sir is. Amrit is also having raising hand.
Yeah, okay, sir. Amrit sir.
Amrit, you can.
What are the cases I filed? I already got the certificates.
Still anything to be filed, Amrit, you can take the opportunity.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Amrit Kumar Kota, Chartered Accountant. First of all, I would like to say that department is putting all its efforts to call the SSCs who are having filed the appeals at the tribunal, and they are also following it up very well. And now the momentum has come. Some of the clients are now wanted to know the advantages of filing this thing, and we are just giving a proactive answer that no, it is the best scheme, it is a golden chance for all the SSCs who are having this type of cases to clear it off. Sir, but only the thing is, now being a Christmas holidays, 2-3 days we may not work. And we would like to know, is there any chance for further extension of time for another 30 days or something like that? Definitely we'll get a very good response for the Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, sir. Thank you.
I am coming in here.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
With regard to any chances of extension, only last week, the Revenue Secretary took a meeting of all the principal chief commissioners all across India, and it was a categorical possibility of further extension to the scheme. This may be noted. Yeah, and also I want also to give you a brief statistics on the progress of the scheme in APN Telangana. As of now, nearly 17 to 18 out of every 100 litigation has come under the scheme. We want, with your efforts, that this number should rise to at least 30 to 35. I want that with the proactive support from the tax bar and the trade association, we may reach that level, because litigation actually not just a cost of money, but also it is a also energy and infructuous energy at that. Energy can be utilized for other purposes, for purpose of business. They are being utilized in fighting tax litigations. So the point is that take all efforts to convince your members, and through the members to their clients, that the scheme is like no other scheme of the Government of India. It gives power not only to decide the case of the taxpayer as filed by it, but also it also decides, he can also decide the fate of the government's appeal against him. So this is an opportunity never to be lost. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Ramesh, please go ahead.
Sir, a small this thing. Though we have receiving the communications for the appeals filed by the SSE, we are not getting any communication for the appeals filed by the department. So since there, I think the SSE have got a very good benefit of 50% of the disputed tax. I think a communication from the department regarding the appeals filed may help us in advising the SSE to go for this declaration, sir.
Can I direct this question to Anil Kumar?
Sure. Sorry, kindly unmute yourself, sir. Mr. Anil. So, Mr. Anil Kumar, sir, you are on spotlight, sir. Kindly unmute yourself, sir.
I'm unmuted. I'm very much there, but I'm not getting to this thing. I don't know, something wrong. I don't know. I've now unmuted and I'll again come into this. Okay, right. Is it numbering or defect in there?
Devidas sir, do you want to ask a question, sir? Hello?
Ritesh is having some queries.
Yes, sir. Devdas sir is online.
Problem. He is trying again to unmute himself. In the meantime, yes. Whatever is there.
Devdas speaking. Sir. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Devdas, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. We are very much able to hear you. Please proceed if you are.
Yes, sir. Devita, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
In the circular of 21st, 4th December 20, the recent circular, 4th December 20, in response to question number 59, there is an issue regarding where an appeal is pending and an application for condonation has been made prior to the date of this circular, then the appeal is admitted by the relevant authority. Then before the date of declaration, the delay should have been condoned. But how far is this practicable? Let me give you an illustration. In respect of departmental appeal, I am saying in respect of a departmental appeal, the appeal was dismissed. And then the department has filed an MA, and the MA is posted for hearing on 29th January 2021. Now, how is this delay going to be condoned before the date of filing of the declaration? Although it's a departmental appeal, the SSE wishes to avail the benefits of the scheme. I do not know why the authorities are craving about this particular issue of the delay being condoned. Once an appeal is filed, whether there is a condonation of delay or not, it is an effective appeal. There is a Supreme Court decision on this issue. Therefore, it seems to me the question of all this condonation of delays being condoned and the appeal being admitted before the date of declaration, that is 31st December, may not be practicable at all. This MA application filed by the department is pending disposal. The SSC has also written to the tribunal to take up the matter, but I do not know how in such a short time it is going to be done. So therefore, it seems to me, once an MA is filed or once a condemnation of application is filed, then the appeal has to be admitted, the declaration has to be admitted, because once an appeal is filed, the question of it being condemnation or non-condemnation does not arise. There is no concept of effective appeal in my personal submission. This needs radio, this needs clarification. In fact, I have raised this particular issue many a times in many a forum, but there have not seems to be any proper reply on this particular issue. Another issue, the total demand of refund. Now, it is in many cases, when the CIT appeals dismisses an appeal of an SSC, the modification orders are passed without any delay. If the appeal is allowed in favor of the SSC by the CIT appeals, the modification orders are yet to be passed or yet to be delivered to the SSC. Therefore, the submission is, how am I going to go about the disputed tax? Do I make my own calculation or do I wait for the modification order, which I don't see forthcoming before 31st December? The modification orders giving effect to CIT appeals order in many cases are yet to be filed. And on account of this COVID, we are not allowed to enter the department premises. Emails are given, but still it is pending. Thirdly, suppose there is a refund due in a particular issue. The refund has been determined. The refund has been determined but not issued. Am I not entitled to take it into account as a payment of tax? Because there is a column in the amounts of paid. There's one more column whether any refund has been adjusted. Refund has not been issued. Refund, once a refund is determined, I have every, the SSC has every right to adjust it. Therefore, will I not be right in adjusting the refund due which has not been given to me and adjust it towards the disputed tax area? These are my questions. Thank you.
Okay, let me try answer the three queries. The first one with regard to condonation and with reference to answer number 59 of the FAQ of April 2020. The point is the terms of the Act, of the DTVSP Act, it makes a reference to an appeal pending as on 31st of January 2020 for making a valid declaration. And in so devising the scheme of the Act, appeals which are belated or an appeal is not only limited it is not only limited by the extent of time within which it has to be filed, but there are many other issues involved with appeal, the valid appeal. For example, payment of admitted taxes, maybe number one, number two, and maybe admitted taxes as per return of income. So there are various angles involved in constituting an appeal. I'm not saying about valid, about effective appeal, but what I'm saying is that while devising that the scheme of the Act, maybe, you know, these things, these concerns were taken into account, and they made it a point that the appeal, if it is belated, then it has to be condoned. So that is why that question 59 came up. And if question 59 has an issue with regard to interpretation, Devita sir, we are there to help you out in piloting your application through. Let us see how it goes. So this is number one. And number two is with regard to, can I have that question, number two question?
Yes, Mr. Siddiqui. Yes, please.
Okay. Yes. What is the question number two, Mr. Devijas? Yeah, if I remember correctly, one of the questions was with regard to giving appeal effect. In appeal effect, so after giving appeal effect, the taxpayer would know the actual quantifiable demand after the appeal, so that he will get under the VSB. I am pretty sure that there could be cases in AP and Telangana where appeal effect has not been given properly for the taxpayers to come under the scheme. Those cases, if there are tricky cases or there are cases of delayed appeal effect or delayed rectification, those cases need to be brought forth to the attention of the designated authority as early as possible, so that justice is done to you and you are not deprived of availing of the benefits of the scheme. So there are two points which I make, that condonation of delay in filing of the appeal as per question number 59 of the FAQ, that to us is a proposition, no matter the many legal arguments against it. And with regard to the appeal effect, delay in appeal effect, the cases may kindly be expeditiously brought before the designated authorities for them to take a call right there and then. Thank you.
There is one question in the chat box, sir. I'll read it from Rupala Rajashekar. Rupakala Rajashekar. In our case, we are waiting for rectification order as there is an error in assessment order with respect to tax calculation. We are following up the matter since February 2020. How to resolve this issue?
I will share the address and the telephone number of the local court election committee and also the designated authorities. There are 12 designated authorities. I will share their name, their email address and telephone number, and also of the local coordination committee who can help you write. Maybe, you know, I will give this particular submission to the host of this webinar, maybe after the end of this meeting, so that you can pass on to anybody of your fraternity who is interested in coming under the scheme. And all these actions with regard to delayed rectification, delayed appeal effect, at this point in time, they can be quickly taken care of.
Sure, sir. We'll definitely do that, sir. Any other questions? Members can unmute themselves and ask to carry.
Sir, now our majority of the taxpayers and tax practicing people are busy in audits and return filing, so they are unable to concentrate more on the Sivas Se Vishwas. You, as our President Amrit Kumar Kota, was also raising same concern. So is there any chance of extension for this tax audit and return filing dates, sir, so that we can concentrate more on Sivas Se Vishwas?
Sir, this question has already been answered, and the answer is no.
Okay. Ritesh, any other question?
No, sir, there are no more questions. I will hear, sir.
Ramesh Jain is asking some questions.
Yes, sir. Ramesh, please go on, sir. Kindly unmute yourself, sir, Ramesh, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir, please go on. We are able to.
Devidas was asking about the third query was regarding adjustment of refund against tax payable under the scheme. So that I think we have to get it from sir, the clarification from sir.
Okay. There are two broad things to be told here. One is that any tax which is paid pursuant to determination of due taxes under the VSB, that is never to be refunded, number one. If you are to pay some taxes under the VSB Act 2020, it is not to be determined. Number two is that while determining the tax due under the VSB, all the taxes paid earlier, they are to be taken into account, meaning thereby those refunds, meaning thereby there's a, there must have been some tax paid. Because of that, some refund is arising. If those tax paid have not been taken credit of, they have not been given credit at the time of determination, those are to be taken care of at the time of determination of tax under the VSB. So VSB 2020 will take into account all the past taxes paid by you. Okay. Refund will arise only if you have paid some taxes or if you are allowed some tax credit through some, you know, TDS and all. Those tax credit and those tax payments which you have made in respect of a particular dispute, they are not to be ignored. It's not a question of refund. While the issue of taxes under the VSB 20 is coming up, it's not a question of refund. It's the question of how much of taxes you have paid in respect of a disputed issue, right? And those taxes, if they have been paid in full or if they have been paid in part, they are to be given 100% credit while you determine our taxes under the VSB Act.
Yes, sir. So there's one
more humble submission, sir.
Yes.
If refund can be conveniently added to tax payable under DTVS, can it be done?
See, you know, it's not a question of getting. See, refund will arise only when we give you tax credit, right? Yes. We give you credit for your TDS or your advance tax or your self-assessment tax, then only the refund will come. While we determine your the dues under the VSB Act, all these payments, past payments, they will be given credit, yes. Right?
Yes.
Then there will be a final demand or a refund that will come. So if there is a demand due, you pay the demand. If there is a refund, we make the payment of that refund under the Act.
Okay. Yes, sir. So there's one more question from Prabhati Kavi Bharat. Is there a delay in getting the Form 3? How long does it take at the high end, sir?
Yeah.
Power banker.
Right. Under Section 5 of the DTVS Act 2020, designated authority gets not more than 15 days to issue the form number 3. I admit, in APN Telangana, initially there have been delays in issuance of form number 3 because many of the taxpayers also went on revising their initial applications. So therefore, form number 3 is basically a quantification of the demand, right?
Yes.
Giving you the status, the latest status. So that also was getting disturbed because of the various, objections, queries, etc. coming from the taxpayers. So the outer time limit for issuance of form number 3 is 15 days as per the statute. In APN Telangana, it was delayed initially, but now we are trying to streamline all the issuance of form number 3 so that there is no delay. For your information, our rate, gross rate of issuance of form number 3 as on date, including those which have been filed yesterday also, it is now 65%. We grew from nearly 20% to now we are 65%. So hopefully we will make all the issuance of the form number 5 timely as per the statute.
Sir, here one suggestion I would like to say.
Yeah.
Why can't we use a SMS alert that your form 3 is already mailed, so that people will be alert and will immediately respond to that by checking their mail ID.
You have said the same thing when you met me the earlier day. We are trying.
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, yes, I remember that, and we are trying to get it done. But because you know the number of, you know, one designated authority out of the 12 designated authority on an average is not getting more than 100, 150, 200 max, right? There are cases in which one designated authority is having more than 500, right? But there are designated authorities who are not having more than 15, 17, 18, right? So there is always a one-to-one, maybe telephonic connect between the taxpayer and the principal CIT. I don't think that, you know, I need your submission, and if it is feasible, technically feasible, we'll also do that. Yeah.
Ritesh, any other question?
Ritesh ji.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
A small query, sir. Whether this form number 3 issued by the designated authority, is it rectifiable, sir, if there is any mistake? I filed the declaration on 31st of December and I get it after 15 days, and there is some mistake has crept in form number 3. Is it rectifiable, sir?
Yeah, form number 3 is rectifiable. Form number 3 is rectifiable.
So I need to make a fresh application or what, sir?
No. See, the point is, you know, the best thing for you, if there is a determination of demand in the form number 3, which you think is prima facie incorrect.
Correct, sir.
Then you go back to the designated authority saying that this is my correct demand, and you show him or her the evidences, right? Then he or she will take a call on that one, right?
Okay, sir.
Sir, Mohapatra, sir, Dahiman here. Sir, while filing the application online, we are again getting your Aadhaar is not linked to the PAN. Actually, it was done before and it's an audit case. Again, we are facing this issue from last 3 days.
Okay, you have a particular specific case in mind? You want to share that case with me?
No, I mean personal. Yeah.
Okay, right. We'll decide on that one. No problem. Yeah.
Sure.
Any more questions, Ritesh, in chat box?
No, sir. That's it, sir. One question what they have to ask is, how will we get the contact numbers and email IDs mentioned by Mohapatra, sir? So, sir, as well.
There's one more question in the chat box, Ritesh. Please check. Then, somebody has put just now.
Interest levied under section 234D, interest on excess refunds, is covered under the scheme. Is it covered under the scheme?
Interest under?
234D.
234D. See, point is, interest per se, if it is disputed and lying in appeal with any of the appellate forum, is good to go under the scheme, right? So interest, not just the interest, but even the fees under 234E and 234F, they are also included, right? So I do not, there is no reference of 234D, or there is no reference of 234ABC also in the scheme of the Act, but it says interest, then a dispute on interest. If that dispute on interest is a matter of appeal, is a matter of dispute, and the dispute and the dispute is lying in an appellate forum, which is referred to in the Act, then I think there is good enough ground for the case to go under the scheme.
No, sir, here the question is that, sir.
Yeah.
234, the interest is on refund. which is available to the SSE. It is not an issue. So he wanted to know whether how it will be treated. So taking analogy from the refund, what you have said, it is a separate thing, will be refunded separately, or it will be adjusted as taxes, TDS, etc. So how it will be adjusted in the amount payable under Vivad Se Vishwas?
No, see, you know, the short point I was trying to make is that you are not entitled to any refund. Sorry, any interest on refund of taxes already paid. If you are coming under the scheme, you are coming under the scheme, then the taxpayer is not entitled to interest on refund. That is very clear. And if you are paying taxes under the VSB, suppose there is a particular demand, 100 rupees, and you have paid by way of regular taxes, when the appeal is pending, you have paid 50 rupees, and there is a 50 rupees which you have to pay under the VSB, and you pay the 50 rupees under the VSB, that 50 rupees can never be refunded under any circumstances, right? But against the 100 rupees of demand, if you have paid 120 rupees, 20 rupees will get back as refund, but there will be no interest on this 20 rupees.
Okay.
Right?
Hello. Sir, you are able to hear me, sir? Because of some connecting issue, I could not get connected. I'm the person who posted this 234D. Sir, I mean, are you, my voice is audible?
Yes, yes, we are able to hear. Please go on.
This is, the question is with reference to, say, supposing 143.3 read with 147 or whatever it is, in the subsequent thing, assessment in 147, say, originally, after arriving at taxes, refund has been made, but in 147, some disputed income has been added. And because of that disputed income, originally because refund has been issued, now 234D has been levied on the refund which has already been made. So this 234D has been levied because of this disputed addition. Otherwise, the original refund would have been there with me. Because this disputed addition is there, the original on the original refund they made, they levied this 234D. Whether this 234D can be exempted, can like 234ABC, whether because this is interest related to disputed addition only, whether that can also be covered? That's my question.
I would not venture into answering this question right now. I would only guide you to either or both. Go to the designated authority who is having jurisdiction or to the local coordination committee. I will get to hear the question from the local coordination committee so that it becomes clearer to me. In a webinar, it is very difficult to, you know, look at the case, look at the facts, and because this is not a cut and paste kind of case, it's not a normal case. So I will not venture into answering this right now, please.
That's fine, sir. Thank you.
So here we have Nitu Gupta madam has posted the email IDs and phone numbers. In case if they have any issues, they can contact them. They are there in the chat box. We have noted the details and we will circulate to the members also. And yes, Randeep sir.
Yes. Thank you, Ritesh. Sir, really, it was a good webinar. I will say not webinar, but like a class to understand some conflicting views and issues relating to the scheme. And again, I urge all the participants to avail of this scheme. Really, it is a very good one. Sir, I have filed a few applications and yesterday only I have received a Form 3. When I met you personally, I told you that so far I have not received. Yesterday only I have received and I have sent the challan to SSEs also. As soon as they make the payment, I will submit Form 4 also. So only one thing I want to know, sir, here. Sir, shall we write a letter to the CIT appeal before making the payment or after making the payment that we are withdrawing the appeal?
See, when you file your form number 4, you enclose the tax payment details, including the BSR code, etc., and also proof of withdrawal of appeal.
Yes, sir.
Your letter to the CIT appeal or to the tribunal that you have withdrawn the appeal, that may kindly be enclosed along with form number 4.
That is fine, sir. What I was actually asking is, when shall we write a letter to the appellate authority while immediately after receiving form 3 or after making the payment?
No, all the two tasks in a sense is, one is making the payment of tax and the second withdrawal of appeal.
Yes.
They are contained in one form.
Achha.
That is form number 4, right?
Yes.
So you have to do both before filing your form number 4 to us.
Simultaneously.
Simultaneously.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you. So again, I thank very much, sir, to you and all the senior officers who have joined. And really, it was enriching our knowledge regarding Vivad Se Vishwas. It has been a long time since we read it earlier. After advent of so many FAQs, we got dazzled in all these things, where it will take to us, and so many questions and answers were there. Any are there? And I will request all the participants on behalf of Tax Bar and Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce and Industry to avail this opportunity of Vivad Se Vishwas and see that our Telangana and AP becomes undisputed, as all the appeals which are pending are settled through Vivad Se Vishwas. It is my humble request, so that we can set a good example to all the other taxpayers all over the nation. So with this brief, I hand over to Ritesh for further final proceedings. Ritesh.
Thank you, Dr. Gutraji. Sir, thank you so much, sir, for taking the details of the scheme. And we, on behalf of Telangana Andhra Pradesh Taxpayer Association and the Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce, request all the members to avail the scheme. We thank all the department members for coming and giving us the time and enlightening us on the scheme. And as a formal vote of thanks, I request CA Sambhumurthy P to propose a formal vote of thanks. Over to CA Sambhumurthy.
Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to propose a very well-deserved vote of thanks, sir. Sir, Principal CCIT, sir, Government Union Department has come out with various schemes to settle the disputes and to give relief to the assessees. And as per my knowledge and my education goes, sir, this Vivad Se Vishwas is one of the best schemes, sir. We have been educating our clients about this scheme. And to the extent possible, all my appeals we have gone under Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, sir. So we are also expecting, as already shared by you, we have started receiving form 3, sir, and we are in the process of filing ITR, making the payment and filing the ITR for what you call the form 4 also. So we are all educating, sir. Only hitch is all are coming at one time, sir. GST also last date 31st December. Income tax also 31st December. Here one hitch is, sir, all non-audit and audit case, everything is 31st December. So that problem we are facing. In spite of that, the disputes or disputed cases are less. We have already educated, and to the extent possible, we have already filed form 1s, and we are waiting form 3s and everything. Only request is, if possible, at least the return filing for non-audit cases, if it can be, not for audit, sir, audit is extended. So non-audit cases, which can be extended to January, will be much relieved, sir. So only with that request. And I thank Principal CCIT, sir, and other commissioners who graced the occasion and shared in the, under the reach out program. It is just like now, it is a final opportunity, sir. You are educating continuously. You are making us aware of more and more points with FAQs and many more things. And also personal interaction through webinar, because of Corona, through webinar. we are very fortunate to know, and we will try to further proceed, and we will request and make this scheme aware, and we'll try to make it successful, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
So
thank you. Thank you. Thanks, all. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So with this, we come to the end of the session. We thank the department and Sir J.V. Manohapatra, sir, for taking venturing us this time. Sir. So with this, to the end of the session.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.